Today we have Higashimaru Spicy Tonkotsu. I've never had this noodle before, so it's going to be a first for me trying it today. It cost £4.99 for 5 packets, so £1 a packet, which is fairly standard for a sort of premium instant noodle. I think this is only the second time I've reviewed a Japanese noodle on this channel. I think you can probably tell by the noodles I review. I usually would go for a Korean or Chinese noodle over a Japanese ordinarily, but that doesn't mean I don't absolutely love Japanese noodles, and you know, I'm really excited to try this today. I have to say, I've never had spicy tonkotsu in real life either. Not just in the instant ramen form. I have had normal tonkotsu many, many times, and I've always come away thinking that it was 10 out of 10. I've never once thought, oh, that really needs some spice to elevate it. But I appreciate that spicy tonkotsu is an authentic dish, so I'm really intrigued to see what this is going to be like. Okay, in terms of packaging, I should probably start by saying I absolutely love pretty much all Japanese packaging. This is already pretty close to a perfect noodle packet for me in terms of the quality of the graphics and the packaging overall. The serving suggestion is strong. The graphic design is amazing. I love all of this. Typography looks absolutely beautiful. Product of Japan, one serving, animal free, so I'm not clear on whether that means it's vegetarian or vegan, but overall aesthetically it is absolutely excellent. And then you've got also this foil kind of packaging with a little notch at the top, so they really do think of everything. On the back, we have some beautiful graphics for those cooking instructions. I think they look really appealing. Boil 400 mils of water in a pan, add noodles and simmer for 2.5 to 3 minutes. Turn off the heat and add the powdered soup. To eat, serve in a bowl and topping with your favorite ingredients. Fair enough. I have absolutely no idea what's going on here, but I just love the aesthetic of this. I really, really love Japanese packaging, so I'm a real sucker for it. I'm really happy with that. I do have an ingredients list over on the outer packaging for the 5-pack. So usually you've got all the noodle stuff at the start, then soup powder, salt, sugar, oil, okay, some flavor enhancers, garlic, ground white sesame seeds, chili pepper, leeks, bunch of other stuff, sesame oil, black pepper, dried carrot. Okay, so you can kind of get a sense of the flavors to expect here from the sesame and the garlic. Okay, I think it's time to go inside, and I'm gonna try the notch, I think. And let's see what this is like. Okay, that was pretty good. Pretty simple. We have some noodles and we have a packet. Let's have a look at these noodles. Okay. So the first thing to note on those noodles is they are thin. I understand though that it's traditional to have thin noodles in a tonkotsu, so I'm not going to complain about that. I think the cooking instruction said 2.5 to 3 minutes. Because these are so thin, I'm definitely going to go for 2.5 rather than 3 and see if that makes a difference. I'm actually going to smell this as well. Yeah, it smells lovely. It smells like a nice packet of crisps. Again, just really nice smelling savory noodle smell to that. Okay, going to open this. I was so impressed by that notch at the start. I feel like I'm going to try and just tear this one as well. Perfect. That looks really, really nice. Definitely glowing orange. So that'll be the spice in it. The color is something I wasn't really necessarily prepared for. I'm gonna give this a smell. All right. So I was definitely getting some sesame with the first smell. Overpoweringly, on the second smell, it was garlic that was coming through with a little bit of pepper. Okay, so that sort of smells, it's so oniony that it smells like a packet of really strong cheese and onion crisps. Smells really, really nice. Doesn't really smell of chili at all at this stage, but I'm okay with that. Right, that's everything. Really simple. It's time to cook it up. Okay. So I decided to cook that for 2.5 minutes, and knowing that the noodles are so thin, I decided not to agitate the noodles while I was cooking it. I kind of just left them in a block. They seem to have softened really well and they don't look overcooked, which is quite good. Those noodles actually look brilliant. Look at the color of that soup. Really, really interesting. I wasn't expecting that color at all. Okay, I'm gonna start by giving this a smell. Okay. Definitely oniony, definitely garlicky, but I'm actually smelling the noodles. It smells like nice, delicious, savory noodles. I'm getting a little hint of sesame as well. Yeah, but unusually, I can, I think, smell the noodles, which is really unusual for this kind of stage. That kind of really nice, savory, kind of fried smell, I guess. A bit like crisps. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Just smells of onion and a little bit of sesame. Okay, let's try the soup. Okay, wow, that is salty. Oniony and salty, the first sip. Okay, there's a really subtle heat coming through. I wonder if it's gonna start overtaking everything else, but my mouth is wakening up. But you know, I'm starting to get that kind of really tonkotsu, savory, meaty flavor now. Really, really umami, really nice. The more of that soup that I drink, the more it just tastes like literally just a spicy tonkotsu. Very delicate, but really meaty, you know, very, very savory. But there's no one overpowering aromatic smell. It's not like the garlic or the onion or the sesame or the pepper or anything is taking over at all. It just tastes like a really nice meaty broth. That is so nice. The umami just makes you want to keep drinking more and more and more of it. Okay, let's see what these noodles are like. It's time to go in. Wow, those noodles are so bouncy. Considering how thin the noodles were, I mean, they're starting to thicken up a little bit. They're surprisingly bouncy and not overcooked. I'm really impressed by the quality. Really salty, really delicious. You could just keep eating those noodles all day. But the mouthfeel is really what sort of jumps out for me. I do think not agitating the block of noodles while they were cooking was a good idea, because these noodles have just turned out perfectly, really. Sometimes the flavor really changes as you get to the bottom of the bowl, so I'm curious to see if that happens. But at the moment, it's really just tasting like a really nice umami bowl of noodles. Extremely salty, but not overpowering in any one flavor. Really quite inoffensive, actually. Like, I could imagine a lot of people enjoying this. Wow, it is so savory. Wow. Okay. So that actually wasn't anything like what I was expecting. When you look at the cover, the broth there is bright red and the packaging is very red generally. So you think this is gonna be a super spicy bowl of noodles, but actually that's one of the mildest noodles I've had in quite a while, and probably the mildest noodle that's been labeled as spicy I think I've ever had. Now there's definitely heat there. I can feel my mouth tingling a little bit, but it's definitely taken a back seat to all of the other stuff that's going on. In terms of the noodles, I was a bit worried when I saw how thin they were, but they came out really, really nice. I'm really impressed by those. The broth was really, really nice, really meaty, really umami. The whole thing was very savory. You want to just keep going and going and going. Like, you want to have the other four packets out of the five pack right now. I don't think I got any really, really particular highlights in terms of aromatics. So there wasn't any sort of over the top garlic smell. There weren't any sort of over the top sort of even the porky taste to it. I know it's animal free, but a tonkotsu broth is really meaty. It tasted meaty, but there was no specific porky flavor there. Same with the sesame, same with the pepper. I think it was really well balanced, and that's why there was no one thing that sort of jumped out. It felt like it was a coherent bowl of noodles, but I am wondering if there was anything there that was really, really memorable for me. Is there anything that I would sort of miss if I couldn't get it again? There are loads of other tonkotsu instant noodles. It's nice having the spicy option, but you could achieve the same thing just by putting a little bit of cayenne pepper into your tonkotsu. You don't really need to go out and buy a specific pack of spicy tonkotsu for that. I think the noodle quality was really strong. And I think overall, the convenience of it just being a packet and some noodles with a short cook time and seemingly quite high quality ingredients, I think is probably the appeal for this. The sort of reliability and the sort of mass production element. I do wonder if it's worth £1 as well. You can get cheaper tonkotsu, like the Nishin Demi Ramen, which is really, really nice. Admittedly, the noodles there were nowhere near as good as the noodles here, but does it justify the extra price difference? And look at all the other noodles that you can get for £1 as well. So I think all in all, I would recommend these noodles. I think they were high quality. I was pleased with the overall quality. So all in all, I would definitely recommend these noodles. They were really, really nice. I think they were really accessible. I think a lot of people would like that bowl of noodles. The quality of the noodles was strong. The broth was really, really tasty. Other than that, I don't think there were any specific standouts. So it's not something that I think I would be dreaming about. I don't think I would be particularly upset if this was no longer on the shelf. So for me, all in all, that's a 3 out of 5 in terms of a rating. Let me know in the comments if you agree or if you disagree. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.